செய்தியாளர்களை சந்தித்து வரும் நேரலை காட்சிகள்
That for the first time revealed the damage wrought by COVID-19, brought forward the need for an off-cycle meeting of the Monetary Policy Committee, that is the MPC, in lieu of the earlier scheduled meeting between June 3rd to 5th, 2020. Over the last 3 days, that is 20th, 21st and 22nd, The MPC reviewed the domestic and global developments and their implications for the outlook. After extensive discussions, the MPC voted unanimously for a reduction in policy repo rate and for maintaining the accommodative stance of monetary policy as long as necessary to revive growth and to mitigate the impact of COVID-19 while ensuring that inflation remains within the target. On the quantum of reduction, the MPC voted with a 5:1 majority to reduce the policy repo rate by 40 basis points, 40 basis points from 4.4% to 4%. Consequently, the MSF rate and the bank rate now stand reduced to 4.25% and reverse repo rate stands reduced to 3.35%. Before I lay out the backdrop, the rationale and expected outcomes of the MPC's decisions, I wish to thank the committee members for their valuable contribution during the deliberations. I would also like to thank my colleagues in the RBI who have been working tirelessly in RBI's fight against COVID-19. My gratitude goes out to our teams for their intellectual support, analytical work and the logistical arrangements. A special word of praise for our team of what is now about 200 officers, staff and service providers who are working unstinted 24/7 in isolation away from their families in order to keep the essential RBI services available to the nation. Once again, I wish to express our admiration for the doctors, the healthcare and medical staff, police, law enforcement agencies, functionaries and personnel of the government, the private sector, banks and other financial institutions who have risen to the occasion day after day through the pandemic to ensure continuity in provision of all essential services. Our deepest gratitude to their families too. I would now like to provide an assessment of the current macroeconomic situation, both global and domestic. By all counts, the macroeconomic and financial conditions are austere. The global economy is inexorably headed into recession. The global manufacturing PMI contracted to an 11-year low in April 2020. The global services PMI recorded its steepest decline in the history of the index. Among advanced economies that have released GDP readings for Q1 of 2020, contractions were in the range of 3.4% to 14.2%. For emerging market economies, the growth rate ranged between 2.9% and -6.8%. EMEs face additional pressures in the form of capital outflows and asset price volatility from the bouts of turbulence afflicting financial markets. The plunge in crude prices has dried up budgetary revenues for oil exporters. On the other hand, oil importers have been denied terms of trade gains by the crushing blow to demand delivered by the pandemic. According to the UNCTAD, the value of global trade contracted by 3% in Q1. The volume of world trade can shrink by 13%.